In God we trust. Yeah, right. We might not have Baal or Asherah, Zeus or Ra, stone idols or stone altars, but today we do have... It can be argued that money is useful. We purchase homes for shelter. We purchase cars for transportation. We purchase food for sustenance. We purchase clothes for protection. It can be argued that money is helpful. We can pay a doctor to treat us. We can rebuild broken communities. We can help those less fortunate. We can give to our church. And let's face it, money can be fun. We use our money. We don't worship it. We save our money. We don't idolize it. Or do we? Some have too much, more than they need, while others don't have much at all, struggling through each day. Yet no matter how much or how little we have, we ultimately find ourselves turning to money. Instead of reaching for God, we reach for our credit cards. Instead of holding God's hand, we grasp our money tightly in our fist. Instead of turning to God, we find ourselves turning to money to solve our problems and fill the empty holes in our lives. We feel bored, but instead of asking God to give us a purpose, we use our money to occupy our time. We feel anxious, but instead of asking God to provide for us, we seek to find our own ways to make ends meet. We feel grief, but instead of asking God to comfort us, we use our money to lift our spirits. We feel desperate, but instead of asking God to relieve our fear, we do drastic things to solve our own problems. We feel lonely, but instead of asking God to befriend us, we use our money to take away the pain. We feel ignored, but instead of asking God to embrace us, we use our money to draw attention to ourselves. Be honest. We all have bowed our knees to money in one way or another. We hunger for more, yet can't be filled. We thirst for more, yet can't be quenched. Our focus on it can become so narrow that it can block out God's love, God's light. All we have then is darkness. But we have hope. There is only one God, the Creator, who has given us everything for life on earth. Our homes, our jobs, our clothes, our food, and ultimately, our money. All that we have comes from God and God alone. To some, He has given a lot, but much is expected. If you have more than you need, remember who gave it to you. Go to God and ask Him to open doors where you can help others with His money. To some, He has given a little, but He promises to provide. If you are struggling to make ends meet, remember who gives you everything you need. Go to God and ask Him to help you trust in His provision. God already knows all of our needs, both rich and poor alike, the voids, the holes in our lives that money can never fill. By freely giving up His Son, He paid a price that we can never fully comprehend, nor ever fully repay. all this was a priceless gift that He, because of His great love for us, was more than willing to pay. Jesus did not die and rise again to save only our souls, but rather, He died for all of us, to save, maintain, and transform every aspect of our lives. God, in His great love for us, wants to tear down that altar to money that we have built near the foot of the cross and restore us to a perfect and priceless relationship with Him. The only thing God asks in return is our trust. Only then will we truly understand the true meaning of wealth. Hear God's promise to us. Don't be obsessed with getting more material things. Be relaxed with what you have. Since God assured us, "I'll never let you down, never walk off and leave you," we can boldly quote, "God is there, ready to help. I'm fearless no matter what. Who or what can get to me?"